When I was pregnant with you, it was strange, you were different. They wanted me to terminate, but I wouldn't. They don't understand you. And I never will.
Fight.
You know, I really like it, but then I really liked Drive, and it makes me wonder if Nicolas Winding Refn and Ryan Gosling have learned anything from the Drive experience. And I know a lot of you are going to defend Drive, and I think that Drive is a good film, but it's not a mainstream film. It performed on par with, like, Hannah, a film like that, and interestingly, those films all open with around 11 million, and they all get to a certain point, and it seems there's only a certain number of people who are interested in that type of movie. And I know that, I recently interviewed Ryan Gosling, and he said that Drive was their attempt, he and Nicolas Winding Refn, to make a superhero film. And obviously it didn't take on the way they had wanted it to. He expressed some disappointment in that. So I applaud them for working together again. I think they're both very talented and I like how ambitious they are. I think to make, I believe this takes place in Thailand, and I love the way that the credits change from that language to English, and I love the use of the setting, and I absolutely love having a foreign actor have such a large role in the film. I think that's so important. I think that a more mainstream version of this film to me is Kill Bill, which also had a wonderful use of color and actors and a foreign environment, although I believe some of that was on sets. But, and even Kill Bill only could reach a certain level. I mean, it certainly has stayed in the pop culture consciousness, but it wasn't a hugely successful film, not anything like what Tarantino is making today. That's why he focuses more, he's moved on to these the Inglourious Basterds and Django Unchained type of movie, because that's been much better for him. Although I really liked Kill Bill. So I want you to understand that when I talk about this trailer, you know, I'm trying to, you know, I'm separating my personal opinion from what I think overall, because I really want to see Ryan Gosling succeed. I find it a little frustrating that he's so talented and I think such a movie star, but I feel that he makes choices that kind of get in his own way. I know he said he wants to take a break and he's going to move over into directing, and I feel that I don't think he's ready to take a break. I don't think he's had that huge hit. I mean, I think that even The Place Beyond the Pines, which is an excellent film which I highly recommend, hasn't gotten great reviews across the board from, like the traditional critics. So, I mean, he's not leaving on a high note. But I like this film. It'll be interesting to see if he can get beyond the audience that went to see Drive, this 11 million opening. I don't know, though. I think this trailer, I like it, but I feel anyone who saw Drive is going to be like, I saw that film and I didn't, you know, whoever didn't like it is not going to like this. The storyline, they don't really go into it here, but from what I've seen, I like the fact that it has a female crime boss in the film, that Kristen Scott Thomas. That's his mother, and his brother gets killed by that other guy, I believe, the Bangkok guy that he challenges to a fight at the end, and he wants to get his revenge. His mother's like, get revenge. You know, that's why only God forgives. She's like, get revenge for your brother. So he goes after that guy. I do know also from what I've read that Ryan Gosling gets the crap beat out of him in the film. So I don't know, you know, that might be like awesome, or I don't know how audiences are going to feel about not having their hero win the day. Maybe he will win eventually, but I think at first he's really going to go through the ringer. But I'm a Ryan Gosling fan. I'm going to see it. I'm probably going to buy the soundtrack because I have the Drive soundtrack and I listen to it quite a bit. And I do like Nicolas Winding Refn. He's one of my talent to watch of 2013 with this movie. But I don't know if they don't understand in the mainstream market or they just have an unwillingness to really pander to them. And some of you might applaud that, but I think if either one of them wants to really stand the test of time, they have to get that big, even Matt Damon, who I really applaud for the chances and risks that he takes, needed the Bourne Identity franchise, the Bourne franchise, you know, kind of as this touchstone so that he could go and make those experimental films. And Ryan Gosling doesn't have that touchstone yet, which is going to allow him to do what else he wants. So we'll see. What do you think of Only God Forgives? Do you think it's too much like Drive, or is that an awesome thing? Do you want Nicolas Winding Refn and Ryan Gosling to make it or to not sell out? So write your thoughts down below, and as always, thank you for coming to be on the trailer, not just for the latest trailers, but these quick snapshot reviews. Thanks for watching. Bye.